Thank you. There's a little spot on the California coast known as called the Big Sur Coast. I guess that's what they call it. I only know because I live there. And it's a nice spot, nice, real ecologically clean, environmentally sound. And we grow our kids there, real big and tall, like the guy right behind me here on the Cougas. Is it Congas or Cougas? I can never say it right. But this is Matt Jardine, my son, doing some of the parts. Pop out while Carl Wilson's Carl's recuperating from this. Appendectomy, yeah. That's what they are. Happens to us once in a while. Only once. If you're unlucky enough. Let's see. Anyway, this song, Getting Back to the California Coast, is, very dear to my heart, this part of the area of the country, and it's, we have a song about it. It goes something like this. Let me get the right key out of my fingers here. On my way to sunny California, on my way to spend another sunny day. Let me ask you again. Anybody remember the girls that were out here on California Grove? Mostly guys are sitting with their girlfriend or their wife or whatever. I'm not prying, believe me. But anyway, they were like, look, girls, I didn't see any girls, mother. Chickens that they are. Anyway, that's okay. This guy's macho.
He's the one that was late.
Anyway, you're welcome. Only $5. Wait a second, I can't get too many laughs. That'd be cutting into Andy Bouvetai's territory. Next time we go to Honolulu, get some big mokes to beat me up or something. Hey, bro, I was just talking about you, man. Great act. All right. Anyway, the girls that were out here in California, girls, weren't just any casual chicks we met last night or something. No, you could probably tell. They're highly trained, highly talented, highly good looking. Well, how did that get in there? I don't know. Anyway, expensive? Yeah, we spare no expense. A couple years back, we came to our senses, you know. We're not getting any younger as a rock group, you know. So we figured, rather than trying to chase the girls, we'll just pay them to come with us. Oh, that was brilliant, you know? Genius. Plus, I mean, I got to look at it from the audience standpoint, okay? Hey, I'm in big trouble tonight. Anyway, no. See, the thing is, if you're a guy out there in the audience, you guys can relate to this, right? If you're a guy, then there's not that much to look at, though, right? I mean, yeah. But now, you had half a dozen cheerleaders or something. Now you're talking, all right? All right. That's the way I look at it. Not trying to be Dice Clay or anything, but I'm just... Okay. All right. Anyway, these girls are cheerleaders. That's what. A lot of them come from UNLV. There's one from Memphis State, national cheerleading champions 5 years in a row. But anyway, without any further ado, to help us out on the next song, which is called Be True to Your School. You get it? You're getting the synchrony here. You're getting the humor. Okay. All right, let's bring out the lovely and talented Beach Boys cheerleaders. Yeah! Here we go. Here's the center of the stage land right here. Okay. Yeah. Okay. See, notice we spared no expense. The BB. Right there, that's the Beach Boys. You get it? And abbreviated. All right, here we go. Now, while the girls get spread out, something about a uniform, right? Okay, I gotta talk to the drummer for a minute. Mr. Kowalski, we're gonna start out. Oh, looking good. I like that shirt. Take that shirt. Hey, can you see that shirt back here? I mean, is that a nice shirt or what? That's beautiful. Silk, too. All right, we're gonna start the song, get to the end of the first phrase, and a pause. Right where I pause, a little dramatic drum roll, okay? Boom. Perfect. Okay, good. Keep in mind, this is not an easy song to do, because we recorded it in 1960. I personally don't remember this session my parents drove me to and from. I slept each morning. Some of the older guys in here will tell you all about it, I'm sure. Okay, here we go. Is this too patriotic for words or what, huh? Beach Boys, cheerleaders, oh, I can't stand it anymore. Okay. And you stop looking up at these cuffs, okay? They're really tight, and it's going to do you no good unless you have a periscope or sort of one of those straws. Here we go. All right. Oh, man, this is hard. Can you tell I'm trying to avoid doing the song? You ever tried to avoid doing something like going to work or school or something? That's how I feel about this song. It's not easy to sing a song that you recorded before there was a United States. Yeah, but we're going to try it anyway because we're that kind of guys, all right? Here we go. What's my note? Oh, thanks. You have to excuse me, it's the altitude. It's plus Caesars. It was so nice to bring us that bottle of Ripple for all of us to share. You know, it was nice. We... get a hernia doing that part. Out of Lubbock, Connecticut. All right, we're going to do a little slow dance now, dedicated to all the lovely ladies here tonight. And so if you're here with somebody you'd like to dance slow with, or if you spot somebody you'd like to dance slow with, and they're not with anybody that's violent, now's your chance. In prison, I'm going to look around and see if there's a volunteer to dance slowly. Where?
Right?
You should be a little shy about it.
There.
Yeah. Are you busy right now? Pretty reasonable.
Oh, wow.
Oh, these Indian summers. Love them. Anyway, what we're going to do is a song called Surfer Girl. Have you ever heard that one? Okay. So don't just sit there like a Lawrence Welk audience or something. So grab your partner and twist, you know? Well, or something. Anyway. Okay. Two, three. Thank you. Oh, wow, that's nice. I know. It's hard to be an audience these days. There's so much to choose from, you know. But we appreciate you coming to the Beach Boys show. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Of course, it's a little hard for us too, because, you know, frankly, you know, usually we do these concert settings where the people dance around and they, you know, they sing along, they do stuff like that. So it's a little different for us to be in a casino type setting, because the audience usually is, well, let's face it, they can't hardly wait for the show to get over, so they get back out on the tables. Yeah, isn't that right? A lot of people are here because somebody else wanted to go, you know, that kind of thing. Oh, so we're sympathetic, so we're going to cut the show way short tonight. What we thought we'd start with was some of our raggedy old used car songs. I mean, no mature, sophisticated person in this day and age. This is the 90s, right? Wants to hear a song that was recorded in the early to mid 60s about a car that was used in the 70s. Case in point, Little Deuce Coupe. We can save a lot of time tonight on that one. And there's Little Old Lady from Pasadena. Too juvenile, pubescent, puerile, you know, look it up. Anyway, no, that was by Jan and Dean anyway. Those no surfing hubcap stealing guy. Anyway, then you're losing my train of thought here. I mean, anyway, no, what else? Oh, Little GTO, forgive. Invariably somebody requests a song, you know, when he's, no, it's not, we're not going that esoteric. No, we're talking about 409. Oh, sure. Oh, yeah. These days with the gas prices as they are, I mean, you know, it's a very sensitive issue, these gas-guzzling, big, high-powered cars we're saying about. That's another embarrassing thing. To give you an idea about how old these songs are, you want to know how old these songs really are? Okay, let's start over here. You want to know how old these songs are? They're so old, when we started making them up, there were no imported cars on the road in North America. We had never heard of a Hyundai, for instance, or a Yugo. That was something you did in private. Anyway, so we won't do Shutdown either. That was a car song. That was about a, yeah, but come on, there are a lot of young kids here tonight, and you know, in about 10, 15 years, they're going to look forward to getting their learner's permit. And so we don't want to influence the youth of our country in a bad direction, because that song, Shutdown, was about a drag race. Can you believe it? How embarrassing. Anyway, so we won't do that, nor will we do... Well, come on, we're trying to make concise, save time. Besides those songs, a lot of times people get up and dance, and I know a lot of people here, we'd have health problems. Hey, you sit there like you're watching television, you got to take your shots, you know? I mean, all right, okay. We don't want to get a furniture bill either, you know? Okay, so no. Admittedly, there's one of those songs, classic of cruising, that was number one then.
I get around.
Guy's psychic over here. All right. You did? You saw our last show? Well, here, why don't you just... Where? Here you saw the last show? You mean I said the same shit last year or something? It's getting boring, man. I'm sorry. Sorry, folks. Lost my head there for a minute. Anyway, okay. All right. But I got an addendum to the last year, okay? Listen to this one. He was right. I get around, but we're not doing it, okay? Forget it. All right? We're not doing it. Let's get this one. Even Mick Jagger liked I Get Around. You realize that? The significance of that statement? The global impact? That's because I sing the lead on it. That's
Mick Jagger!
But, which goes to show you, somewhere deep down, there must be some good in Mick Jagger. David Bowie says it was.
Mick Jagger, you know what I mean? And a lot of people out there are going, who? This skinny big lip guy from England runs around the stage trying to be black. He didn't give me no satisfaction, but like I said, he gave David Gore some. I couldn't resist. I had to do it. Anyway, so how many, in spite of the fact that these songs are outdated, there's no blue book value in these cars, how many still want to hear those stupid old dumb cars? You should. Okay. All right, that did it. Let's hotwire the hot rods one more time. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Thank you, my people in the car, people. I'm going to change the pace just a little bit now and do a song from our Pet Sounds album. And Carl usually does it, but in his absence, Bruce Johnson's going to sing this very pretty song called God Only Knows.
Thank you.
Thank you.